I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be clean. I
war. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see. Are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine, she's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move, move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Captain. Hang on. Okay?
You just remember one thing. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations,
no.
And there will be repercussions.
The James and his cheery chatter.
The decorations
look
extremely
like toys in this place will feel.
Just like home.
It's just something you get used to down here.
Come on.
Come on. Walk to Daddy.
Daddy.
There you go. My goodness, just old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of you. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her.
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised... Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him... You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
Enjoying yourself?
Are you having a nice time?
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Isn't this great, Ursula?
Are you having a nice party? Goodness, listen to me. Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, not like today. So few young people now. But here I am. Here you go.
It's time to cut the cake.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still...
Having a good time. It wasn't easy.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all... As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I... Don't me... Oh.
Keeping this a secret. Now go on.
Daddy,
I'm sure everyone else would like a chance.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll, you... Oh, yeah? We'll see.
All official.
Gonna be sorry.
I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nonsense. People...
Butch, what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone.
Nice party.
You all right, son?
Come on, Wally.
You didn't
hurt me. Always have good ideas.
Thanks for coming, Stan.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was? Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to...
I know you were busy with the water purifier.
What are you looking at?
Everything's fine, I hope.
All right, Butch. Oh, sure, nothing to worry about.
Hey,
me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
Nice party.
I wasn't worried.
Can it? I've had it with
anything,
you, Butch.
Right?
Your mother is going to hear about this little incident.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I... Jonas...
Happy birthday.
Let me tell you, it's my fault? So, what do you think we should call our gang?
How are you enjoying the party, Mrs. Palmer?
Happy birthday, dearie. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? And now look at you. Since this was such a special occasion. Of course. Run along.
Tolerate anymore.
Overseer's authority is absolute.
Oh, really? They're lovely.
For now, just remember, I'm keeping my eye on you.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't al- You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad...
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy and your own BB gun. Jonas found it down here. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and good work. Let's get a picture together. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls, different hearts.
It's important anyway. So, I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what?
That
like, I get any
Gloria.
Kind of special
Tell
treatment.
Me.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a... No. When I started studying, you'll do fine. And most... Hey, it's not my... Come on.
You better stay away. I don't want you to catch what I've got. Careful with that.
Morning, Jonas.
Morning, Doc. How's things?
Have you had a chance to look over these results? I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata. Yeah? What do you want? None of your business. If you mess with the tunnels... Maybe you're right. We can deal with her later. Come
Thank
on, tunnel
God
snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because... Thanks for getting rid of them.
Good morning. Good luck with the goat, buddy.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust... I'm sure you will. We'll start as...
Get out of my face.
Good luck on the goat.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr.
DeLoria. I've got other things to do. Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Back off. What is it, Phoebe?
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Well, well. Pip-Boy programmer, eh? Stanley will finally have... Yes, good to know that the goat occasionally... Well, I'm glad things turned out so...
I've got other things to do.
Remember, only you can.
I'll see you tomorrow, right now.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
Daddy's
Dr. Brock
here to save you now. Is he helping you
get back
to
work?
So
what are you gonna do now?
Selfish and insubordinate.
Look, just
you wake need
up.
To know this.
Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man.
Get
before...
out of...
Yeah? What do you want?
Class, eh?
Come on!
Thanks for getting rid of him.
Tunnel snakes? This little bitch isn't worth our time.
Well, you made it. We'll...
Fine. Whatever you say, Butch. You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Fine. Let's go. As soon as everyone takes their seats, we can get started.
Morning, Doc. How's things? Have you had a chance to look over these results? I was just going over them. I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready this afternoon.
Sounds good.
Take your seats so we can get started. Go ahead, take a seat so we can start.
Hi, Stan. Sorry to keep you waiting. What seems to be the call today?
As soon as everyone takes their seats, we can get started.
Thanks for getting rid of them.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question eight. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number one. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question nine. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
I've got other things to do.
Back.
Well, well.
Off.
I'll see you tomorrow, right now.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
Daddy,
Mr.
Dr.
Brooks.
Ray here to save you now. Is he?
Get back to work. What are you gonna do now?
Selfish and insubordinate.
Just
wake up.
You need to know.
Come on, wake up.
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on, you've got to wake up. Don't be a smart mouth. This is serious. My father's men are looking for you. They've all... It's your dad. He's left the vault. My father thinks Jonas helped him escape. My God, they killed him. Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry. But we've got... Not anymore, apparently. But are you on... Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Use these again. Oh. Okay.